Hare Krishna.
I welcome everybody to Damodar Kids session. Today's class we are learning Krishna story. Sorry for the interruption that had happened during the call. I would like to sing from Mangala Charan and then we'll start the class, okay? Hope you all can see me. Hare Krishna, I'm just typing here. Please reply me. Okay, let's start our class. Om Ajnanatimirandasya Jnananjanashalakaya Chakshuranmilitanyena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. Nama Om Vishnupadaya Krishna Prastaya Bhutale Shrimate Bhakti Vedanta Swamin Niti Namine. Namaste Saraswate Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschata Deshatarine. Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadara Shri Vasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Okay, today we are learning the Krishna story. Agasura pastime. You're already done. Agasura pastime, okay? So we already saw what happened, how the Agasura entered into the Vrindavan. Who is Agasura? He's a brother of Bakasura and Potana, right? So we already saw that story. Now we will go into the next part of the story, that where we have stopped last week, okay? So, at first the boys thought that the demon was only a statue. So, they thought that was not a real snake. They thought it's a big cave.
It's a big cave
or a statue, okay? Then, what happened? They were talking to each other. It looks like a big, huge snake which has opened its mouth up on the sky
and down to
the bottom, okay?
To the sky and the down layer takes to the ground.
So like they were discussing like this. So then what they were thinking, oh, if it is really a snake.
They were thinking the Agasura demon was scary.
Okay. They were thinking that if it is a really snake, will it swallow us? So then they were also thinking, okay, if it will swallow, Krishna is there with us, right? Krishna will never make us to come into the problem, right? How did Krishna kill Bakasura? How did Krishna kill all the demons that came into Vrindavan, right? So they were thinking, oh, so no, I don't need to get worried about it. So then what happened? All the boys, seeing Krishna's lotus feet, they just went into the cave.
Yeah.
And then what happened? They were without any fear, because when we have Krishna with us, we don't have to fear for anything, right? Mm-hmm. So then, without any fear, they just walked into the cave, into the snake's mouth. So then what happened? We will see. So the demon was waiting for Krishna to enter. Now first, initially you can see all the gopas and the calves. Everything was entering here. But Krishna is here. But Krishna is saying, don't go. But they all went inside. And now when Krishna entered, what happened? You see, that time all the demigods from the sky were seeing all this hiding in the clouds and were seeing this beautiful pastimes. They were, you know, oh, now what is going to happen like that? They know that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, but at the same time, they were so anxious to know what is going to happen. So then what happened? Krishna became bigger and bigger. So that in the throat of Agasura, Krishna couldn't fit. And what did Krishna, what did Agasura happen? You know, it was broke. The throat has broken. And, you know, Agasura could not have any breath and he thus died. So Krishna brought all the boys out of the cave with him safely and sounded right out of the mouth of the demon.
Yeah.
So like that, Krishna saved all the boys.
Okay, I have another question.
And the calves. Okay. So we will see what's the moral of the story.
Vrinda wants to go first.
Quiet, Vrinda. Okay. Mommy is saying you have to listen. So here, what is the moral of the story? The moral of the story is whenever the Krishna is there, we should never have any fear.
Yeah.
So we will see why we should not have a fear.
Yeah, Vrinda wants to go first.
Wait, Vrinda. Nobody is there. We are just doing the story and after that you can talk. Okay, give me some time. So then what happens here? So why do we have a fear? Because we are thinking that we are a body. We are not a soul. So when we'll have a fear? Oh, today something is going to happen to me. Because why I'm thinking that I am a body? If I think that soul, because soul cannot have any problem, because soul cannot be cut, soul cannot be put it in the fire, soul will not have any problem. When we think that we are a body, then the problem arises. So we should come out of the bodily concept, then we'll come out of the fear. So here the moral of the story by one small song.
Yes,
Baja Hure Mana Shri Nandanandana Abhaya Charanara Vindare Durlabha Manava Janame Satsange Baba, which makes one fearless, having obtained this rare human birth, cross over this ocean of worldly existence through the association of saintly person. So how can we come out of this fear? By having the association of a saintly person, by surrendering to the lotus feet of Krishna. We can see the story of Prahlad Maharaj.
Yes.
How the Prahlad Maharaj was coming, was not having any fear, you see.
Yeah, yeah.
Like Prahlad Maharaj was putting under the snake, near the snake.
Yeah.
He throwed away from the top of the hill. Hill and everything. So nothing happened to Prahlad Maharaj, because Prahlad Maharaj is always thinking of Krishna, right?
Krishna.
Okay, now I'll ask you a question, Vrinda.
Okay.
Why were the boys not afraid to walk into the serpent's mouth?
Because Krishna is there. They were thinking that is like a statue. And then what happened? Krishna was telling, don't go from the far away. But they were still walking in there because Krishna's gonna protect them.
Yes,
but
thank
they
you.
Don't know.
Enough. How did Krishna kill Agasura? How did he kill?
With Krishna has powerful. How did he, Krishna?
Because Krishna became.
Because Krishna became big and then Agasura's throat become broke.
And then Agasura died, right?
And then Agasura died because Krishna is powerful, so he can kill demons.
Yes, thank you. Thank you, Vrinda. Today's Bhagavad Gita sloka. Sorry for the inconvenience because of the FCC problem. We are on the live. So I just want to recite this sloka and Anjana Gopika Mataji is going to send us the audio on the call. Okay. Avachananti mamuda manushim तनुमाश्रितं परं भावं अजानन्तो मम भूता महेश्वरम् अवजानन्ति मां मूढा मानुषीं तनुमाश्रितं परं भावं अजानन्तो मम भूता महेश्वरम् अवजानन्ति मां मूढा मानुषीं तनुमाश्रितं परं भावं अजानन्तो मम भूता महेश्वरम् So meaning of
Uta Maheshwaram.
So meaning of this verse is, fools deride me when I descended in the human form. They do not know my transcendental nature as the supreme lord of all that being. So what does the fools think? That Krishna is like us human. Even though he is the supreme personality of Godhead, he's coming like a human form. So that is completely wrong. Krishna is Satchitananda Vigraha. He's complete.
Krishna is our God and Krishna is our Godhead.
Supreme personality of Godhead, okay?
Krishna is our supreme personality, Godhead.
Okay, quite. Okay, the next time.
In his hand and he's playing it.
Okay, thank you, Vrinda. The next one is the rhyme.
I want to go first.
The rhyme, we already did it. I just want to sing once have a complete class. Pre-deities. Three deities, say who they are, say who they are. Jagannath Balad Subhadra, how merciful and kind they are. Belachiko and Ratha Yatra, three deities, three deities. Okay, say, sing.
Three deities. Say who they are, say who they are. Jagannath Baladeva Subhadra, Jagannath Baladeva Subhadra.
How merciful
and kind they are. Three deities. Thank you, Mataji.
Okay, we can end the
Thank
call
you,
here.
Thank you, Mataji.
We can
Pancha Kalpata Rubhyasya Kripa Sindhu Vaevacha Patitana Pampadevya Vaishnavevyo Namo Nama.
Thank you, Pranav, for your beautiful answers. Thank you, kids, for joining once again. Sorry for the inconvenience. Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai. Thank you, kids.
Sorry, Mataji.